Well, tonight we're taking you to what we think may be one of the best in the state, thanks to the unforgettable story behind it.
On this chilly Halloween night, the story behind this pumpkin display in Litchfield will warm your heart.
Amazing. That's a lot of pumpkins.
Mark Mosnica's wife, Robin, would carve dozens of pumpkins for Halloween, a tradition she started more than 17 years ago.
I came home and she had picked, carved, and gutted 65 pumpkins inside of about 6 hours. I mean, she was, and that's, you know, we've been married maybe 10 months. It's like, oh my God, I married a crazy woman.
But last April, Robin died suddenly of a heart attack. She was only 51 years old. Mark, who is living with multiple sclerosis, had no plans to keep her pumpkin tradition going. But then a neighbor stepped up.
A woman in town whose children were bummed out about the pumpkins, they got together in the car, 50 pumpkins. And brought them here and put them here last Sunday night.
Soon, even more neighbors, friends, and family were dropping off jack-o'-lanterns of all shapes, sizes, and designs. The family even received a carful from Fisk Elementary School in Salem, where Robin taught third grade. Now their house is surrounded, aglow with hundreds of pumpkins.
We have somewhere upwards of 325, 350. Out there right now.
People drive from all over southern New Hampshire to see the display, and the Mosnica house is more popular than ever. Mark says Robin would have been thrilled.
I mean, she'd be touched. She'd be so thrilled. It chokes me up every time I think of it, to be honest with you.
And he says it's a wonderful tribute to a woman who took so much joy in making others smile on Halloween.
I'm going to miss her. But, you know, things like this keep her legacy alive.
And again, more than 400 pumpkins were carved and lit up in front of the Mosnica house this year in memory of Robin.
It's fantastic.
Yeah,
really.
People are wonderful.
People really are wonderful.